Today, there are 2 million descendants of French-Canadian immigrants living in New England. These are our stories. Welcome to the French-Canadian Legacy Podcast.
Venez tous jeunes filles et garçons, je vais vous raconter l'histoire de notre immigration ici aux USA. De grands aventuriers, de pays étrangers.
Bonjour everyone, this is Melody with French-Canadian News. It's a short segment today, but there's some great stuff that you don't want to miss. We'll start with an article titled, Franco-American Fiddler's Rendezvous Coming to Lewiston's Kennedy Park. This is an upcoming event on August 8th, so prepare your calendar for next month. Check out Kennedy Park in Lewiston, Maine for Franco-American fiddling featuring a lineup of Maine musicians. Cindy and Don Roy, Erica and Matt Shipman, Steve Muse and Robert Sylvain, Greg Boardman and Neil Perlman, and Pam Weeks. This fiddling event is being sponsored by LA Arts, with funding provided by a grant from the Maine Bicentennial Commission. Chair of LA Arts, Jim Parakilis, said that the organization, quote, would be proud to sponsor a concert by any one of these exceptional musicians who have been integral to preserving Maine's French-Canadian musical traditions. Bringing them together in one concert, we feel, provides our community with a unique opportunity to experience the richness of this musical culture, end quote. Next up, we have a new article from Juliana LaRue titled, Yvon Chouinard Shared His Franco-American Heritage. Chouinard was born in Lewiston, Maine. He's an avid outdoorsman and entrepreneur whose company, Patagonia, is known for its support of environmental activism. In this article, he shares his Franco-American heritage in a personal biography he composed. So check out this interview by reading the article. We have a new blog post from Query the Past by Patrick LaCroix titled, Review, Mayer, Congress's Own. This is a book review of historian Holly A. Mayer's book, Congress's Own, A Canadian Regiment, The Continental Army, and American Union. In the book, Mayer highlights the Canadian Old Regiment, or Congress's Own Regiment, that was established in 1776 during the American Patriots' occupation of the colony. Check out LaCroix's thoughts on this book and be sure to check out Congress's Own by Holly Mayer. There's a new episode of Les Aventures d'un Québécois, capsule number 13. Luke is back with another episode highlighting his adventures en français. In this episode, Luke takes us to City Hall in Shawinigan, Quebec. Check out the full episode to learn more about this location. And now on to events. On July 24th, from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. Eastern Time, check out the Franco-American Walking Tour of St. Francis High School and College on the University of New England Biddeford campus in Biddeford, Maine. This event is free and open to the public. The tour group will meet in the St. Francis Room on the UNE campus. Next week's guest on the French-Canadian Legacy podcast is Dr. Paul LeBlanc. Dr. LeBlanc is the president of Southern New Hampshire University. He was born in Canada, and his family immigrated to the United States when he was very young. You'll learn more about his story and the fantastic work he's doing at SNHU next week. Dr. LeBlanc's time was limited, so we don't have a typical bonus question, but we hope you enjoy this clip, and we'll check back next week. That's all I've got for you this time. Everything I've covered today will be linked in the French-Canadian Legacy podcast episode description. Merci for listening.
And that's what I'm doing in 3 weeks, in fact.
You're going to do immersion school.
I am, yeah. I'm heading up to Quebec City for 6 months.
That's so cool. I mean, so when my daughter went up to New Brunswick to work in the skating community, which is a French-speaking community, she had sort of passable French. And then she decided she really had to be better at it. So she did an immersion program in Montreal. It wasn't 6 months. It might have been a couple of months, 3 months. She has an ability to learn language quickly. So when she arrived back and then could speak with fluency, her welcome and acceptance skyrocketed.
That's awesome.
Because our language marks us as belonging, right? Sure. When you speak my language, we have that connection.
For me, I've never been able to speak with my parents in their first language. And yeah. So that first Sunday dinner when I can is going to be a very, very awesome time for me, for sure. Very much looking forward to that.
Now our fathers look at us and sigh with despair to think that everything they love we simply do not share. But the spirit never dies, our culture will survive. Each of us must choose how much to keep alive. Each of us must choose how much to keep alive.
Special thanks to Josie Vachon for providing the music. You can find more about her at josievachon.com. This podcast was produced and edited by Mike Campbell. If you have any questions or comments, please email us at fclpodcast@gmail.com. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, at FCLpodcast for more information about the topics discussed. If you enjoyed the show, please subscribe and leave us a review on iTunes or wherever you listen to this episode.